part three or an early look at winter. I don't know which one I'm going to title this. But basically, we're just going to be taking another look at the Jamstack and the updated kind of outlook from the Japanese Weather Service. But before we get started with this video, though, I would ask that you do subscribe if you do like weather-related content and you haven't subscribed already. I do lots of monthly forecasts, seasonal forecasts, and all sorts of forecasts for storms that are happening currently, like snowstorms, hurricanes, severe weather events, things like that. Anyway, guys, enjoy the video. Now, this is a model that they use. It's kind of equivalent to America's CFS model. And it tends to do a little bit better with seasonal forecasting than the CFS. It's actually my favorite seasonal model, and we're just taking a look. It updates every month, so we're taking a look at June's updated forecast, which came out in late June. So I'm kind of uploading this a little bit late, but we are going to go ahead and take a look. Now, we can see that there is a lot of precipitation there for the Rockies. That's something to note, as well as the southwestern United States, California as well, Nevada. A little bit drier there for the Pacific Northwest, kind of like it was earlier on in the last few winters. Now, also, we're taking a look at the southeast now, and you can see there is a lot of precipitation for the southeast as well. Actually, the most, as you'll see later on, we're expecting possibly an El Nino to persist, and that would be quite characteristic of that. One thing I did want to note is that the northeast looks a little bit drier than normal. So we're going to have to continue to watch how that plays out. That could play into snowfall totals this winter if it continues to show this. Now, we're going to go ahead and move on to your temperature outlook here from the Jamstack. And you can see we kind of have a pattern that looks a lot like the last few months have, where we have a little bit warmer there up against the west, but really cold for the central United States there. So really through the Dakotas, Montana, Wyoming, Colorado, Kansas, Nebraska, Oklahoma, Texas, that's where the cold is really, really going to set up, it looks like, according to this model so far. In the eastern United States will be slightly below average, but really that central United States looks to be the coldest at this point. So we'll have to see how that plays out, if that kind of goes a little bit east, or if it stays right where it's at, or it could even go west. So we'll have to really keep an eye on where this likes to set up. But as of right now, this looks really cold for the central United States and slightly cold there for the east coast of the United States. Would be a pretty decent setup for the winter, I would say. Now, we're going to go ahead and take a look at one more thing, and this is the ENSO forecast, which is basically your El Nino or La Nina. And you can see if it's over that middle line, it's basically an El Nino grounds. It could be a La Nada, which is none of them, but it looks about to stay just above El Nino status. That 0.5 there line, that's usually our standard for El Nino, and it looks to creep below that and above it a few times there. So I think we're going to be in a La Nada slash very, very weak El Nino, which is a good place to be. Not going to be overpowering or overbearing over anything. So I would go ahead and say that probably we have a winner with a similar ENSO setup to what we had kind of in the earlier teens of the 2014 to 2015. Similar ENSO forecast to winters like that, where we had a very neutral ENSO. Anyway, guys, I hope you enjoyed this little look at winter and what I'm thinking so far as of right now. Obviously, it's July. Next month is really going to be where we're going to start to really wrap up things and start to actually make predictions. But as of right now, we're kind of just taking in the information. And I got a lot of comments in the last winter thoughts video. People were like, oh, it's the first day of summer. Why are you talking about winter? Well, these models are starting to get a hold of what they actually think is going to happen. So we actually do have a really decent idea of what's happening, as well as the teleconnections start to play in, like ENSO. We can take a look at that this early on and kind of have a pretty good idea of what's going to happen, as well as some of the oscillations like PDO and things like that. Anyway, guys, I hope that answered a lot of questions, because I got a lot of comments in the last one where people were like, oh, it's too early. But there is some things that we can figure out earlier on like this. So it's not too crazy to be making a video like this. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching this video, and I really, really hope to see you in the next one. If you haven't subscribed already, make sure to hit that subscribe button. Anyway, guys, see you in the next video.